episode 238 of Save Our Marriage Empowerment segment. In some ways, we do that is with prayer, reflection, inspiration, innovation, courageous conversation, encouragement, enlightenment, evolvement. Also, notice when I'm only using one device, it's not as cloudy or interrupted because it's not pulling so much on the Wi-Fi. So, recording and then uploading to the other social medias is what I'll do until I figure this out, okay? I'm JC Love, teacher love, coach love. This is for healthy-minded husbands and wives and those who are seeking for the healthy, because you brought your self-reliance and independence together to build a bridge, lift one another up, and open up doors. You want the best for and from one another. You're not looking to do any harm. You're all in. You have a vision. You know that marriage is a ministry. It's God's art, and we're the ones that have the paintbrushes to add to the masterpiece. It's what we make it be. I ain't saying that it's easy, and it's not for everybody. Neither are these segments. So thank you for gifting me with some of your time as I gift you with some of mine. I'm going to give you another LDD. It says that love takes initiative. Therefore, God's chosen ones, holy and loved, put on heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility. I prefer gentleness. Because the only one, meekness. Humbling ourselves is for our Creator. That's the only one I feel like we should be lowering who we are. Because how are we shining and bringing forth God's light if we do that with other people? I'm working on not making so many faces. I am. We also have to have patience. Colossians 3 and 12 is where that's found. Kindness thinks ahead. It often takes the first step as well. It doesn't sit around waiting to be prompted or coerced before getting off the couch. You have to have an empathetic heart to show kindness. Those who believe in a higher power, you do, because you're not looking to hurt nobody. The self-love doesn't want you to hurt anyone else, because you see that everyone else is a gift as well. You're not looking to hurt, demean, degrade, disrespect, downplay. You're not the enemy, so you're not seeking to destroy. Now, if you're working for the enemy, that's different. That ain't healthy. The kind husband or wife will be the one who greets first, smiles first, serves first, and forgives first. It's almost like you're competing in a healthy way. I wake up first and I'm fixing breakfast. I'm not going to lay there and wait for you to get up just to fix it. I'm not going to let you do that every day, though. You know, as a kind person, I may end up having to set an alarm or go to sleep earlier because, you know what, my husband got up yesterday and made breakfast. I'm going to get up today and I'm going to make breakfast. Yeah. My wife made dinner, or she made lunch for me to take. I'm going to make lunch for her and myself, of course, to take. Maybe we get home at the same time and we start dinner together. Because yesterday, she beat me home. Or she had dinner waiting. Today, if I'm not going to get home at dinner time, I'm going to bring it and let her know I got dinner. I'm bringing it. Kindness. Okay? They don't require the other to get his or her act together before showing kindness and love. The Lord described kindness of love in the parable of the Good Samaritan. That's found in Luke 10. A Jewish man was attacked by robbers, left for dead on a remote road. How many people walked past him as if, that ain't my business, I don't care, I didn't do it, whatever. Get better when you can. To religious leaders, respected among their people, walked by without stopping. A common man, basic person, of another race, of another ethnicity, actually stopped to help the man, bandaged, cleaned his wounds, carried him to safety, and then paid his bills. Kindness. That man took the initiative and demonstrated true kindness in every way. And when acting from kindness, you see the need and you make the move. You don't pass by and say, well, somebody else can do it. Kindness says, let me. I got it. Today's dare, this one's dare, says, find ways to demonstrate unexpected gestures of kindness to your spouse. Do that throughout the day. So if this is the only one that you see, find ways to show kindness today, throughout the day. And then make it a habit, because that's what healthy husbands and wives do. Yeah, you want to love to life. I appreciate your time. Thank you for gifting it with you as I gift you some of mine. And for tuning in, walk in love, talk in love, look in love, speak in love, do everything in love. Lead and follow in and with love. Listen and talk. In and with love. Make it a lovely day, not just for you. Find someone else and help them have a lovely day too, because you never know what someone is going through. Right? Be loved.